you also lose your mercy. You lose your opportunity for mercy. Your spiritual birthright guarantees your access to God's mercy. Are you listening to me? He said, of what use is the birthright without food? If he has kept his birthright by adventure, he might have found the mercy of the Father. But he himself said, of what benefit is birthright? Give me this porridge. Let me eat and that and just leave. You can have it. The devil said to Jesus, bow down before me and I will give you the kingdom of the earth. Who owns the heaven and the earth already?
I don't know.
And you are telling him that if you buy, you will give it to him. He already had it. He owns it. He created it. You are telling the owner to give, to bow down to get it again. That's an insult. Touch your head, say, keep your back right.
Keep your back right.
Keep your back right.
Jacob found mercy. David found mercy. Every one of us know the story of David. And God, if there was any man that does not deserve the mercy of God, should be that brother. And God said, I have established a sure mercy with David. And they call it the sure mercy of David. That this mercy is the sure mercy of it. So if anybody wants to enjoy mercy, let him connect to the sure mercy of David. Because David does not qualify for the mercy of God. But God qualified him. Jabesh got the mercy of God. He was called a son of sorrow. The mother named him Sorrow. In sorrow I had you. Why? Because when she was pregnant of Jabesh, the father died. And said, you are a son of sorrow. You brought me sorrow. And Jabesh said, oh, that you will change my destiny, that I will not cause sorrow anymore. And God made him to be more honorable than his brothers. Solomon found God's mercy. Brother Solo. Solo was a product of adultery. And God said, somebody is going to be a king in Israel. I choose Solo. There are legitimate sons in the house of David. God said they are not qualified. Who are you to judge God? Can a clay say to the potter, how did you make me this way? People have said to themselves and to people that you are not qualified for anything good this year, everyone will be surprised them by the mercy of God. Peter enjoyed the mercy of God. Somebody get ready because this is your year of settlement.
Amen.
It's coming by mercy of God.
Amen.
As our strange Lord said, God said, if you can introduce my mercy to them, then they access it, then everything is settled. It will not be by qualification. It will not be by right or choice. I will just show them mercy. Peter denied Jesus how many times? Three times. Jesus said to him, Satan has demanded of you, but I have prayed for you. When thou art returned back to me, strengthen thy brethren. Judas betrayed him once. And there was no mercy for him. Jesus prayed for Peter. When he saw the devil was coming for him, he knew the devil was coming for Judas. He didn't pray for him. The treatment was mercy. May Jehovah God pray for you.
Amen.
I say, may heaven pray for you.
Amen.
I say, may heaven pray for you.
Amen.
You don't understand that? I say, may heaven pray for you.
Amen.
May heaven intercede on your behalf.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Peter found mercy. Quickly as we pray, what are the three things that qualifies you for the mercy of God? There are things you can do to access the blessings of God. To access His mercy. Solomon knew that he was not qualified for his mercy, neither for the blessings of God. So that's why he didn't go to God asking for anything. He knew, I'm not a right one to be here. So what claim do I hold in my father's kingdom? So he went as a nobody and just sacrificed to God. He built an altar for God. He created a relationship with his creator. For you to assess the mercy of God, establish your relationship with God this year. Establish what? Relationship with God. Create a serious time of communion with hell. The battles you are trying to handle by yourself, when you are settled with God, God will settle them.
Yes.
Stop looking for enemies. Keep enemies where they are. Look for God this one year.
Yes.
Someone listen to me.
Yes.
Look for God this year. Forget your enemies. They are already doomed.
Yes. Yes.
You didn't say good amen.
Yes.
I said they are already what?
Doomed.
Yes.
But stay with God. One with God is the majority.
That's right.
For if God be for us, who can be against us?
Nobody.
Somebody say nobody.
Nobody.
Have an encounter with God, I beg you, this year. Because it is him that we have mercy on, who you will have mercy on. Have an encounter. In my language, they used to say only that if you understand that grammar. Gira kita odola. Kashishe bielu. Gira kita odola. It means to labor and struggle does not equal riches. It is God's mercy that just brings blessing.
Right.
How many of you know what I'm saying? I am too wise does not equal success. I am better than her does not equal you be lifted. I am more beautiful does not qualify you for the right husband. Is somebody listening to me? There are beautiful ladies with bad situation.
That's right.
An ugly lady with good situation.
That's right. Yes.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Is somebody listening to me?
Yes.
One day I was driving and on a road and I saw a man, very short, dwarfy man. This man is specially dwarf. And he's like this walking. And the lady beside him erected, well built and packaged.
Hey.
Everything is Pajero. And this man, they wear the same dress and they were walking on the road. I say, what? In this life? How did this man capture this woman?
It's
mercy. If he not be love. If he love, now let's see. This man, if you look at him, you say, what is this? Is this a man or a gorilla? But this lady is just walking beside him and they were just doing. I say, husband and wife. May the mercy of God look at you. Mercy gave him that woman. Mercy. If you know God, don't unknow him this year. If you know him, don't disown him. Stay with him. No matter what you are going through, stay with what? Stay with God.
That's right.
Don't leave God for anything. Stay with him. Only him can grant you mercy.
Right.
Only him can favor you.
Right.
Only him can approve you.
Amen.
Only him can fight your battle.
Amen.
Don't run to Abanis. Don't order for charm from Africa.
Amen.
People who should say you are in America, you are calling home. Hey, my mother, no sleep, oh.
Yeah.
No sleep, oh. Walk out for me, oh. Walk out. That's what they do.
Yes.
You are in London, you are in Europe, they say, Mama, walk out. Oh. Your bikini suffer for you, walk out for me, oh, no sleep. Oh.
Yeah.
You don't need Mama to walk out, you need God.
You need God.
Don't send your mother to early grave.
Yes.
You need God. Mama, don't burn you already, burn yourself again. Don't put your burden on man or daddy or mommy or your. Put your burden on God. Seek God. For where cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, who makes the heavens and the earth. Listen to me as I conclude this point. If you don't serve the God of mercy, you will have a miserable life. The reason why people are miserable is that they are not serving the God of mercy.
That's right.
Stay with the God of mercy. Even if he didn't answer you today, we answer you tomorrow.
Amen.
That is why it's called the God of mercy. When he sees your faithfulness, your consistency, your determination, say, oh, that you will bless me indeed. Oh, that you will, because he knew he was not qualified to be blessed. But he said, oh, that if only you can bless me and bless me genuinely. And God, Bible says, and God answered him, granted his desire. Because he stayed with God. Renew your relationship with God this year. A woman called and said, everything was working for her. Every time she's on the prayer line, everything she was getting it. And then suddenly we stop seeing her on the prayer line. And you see me, I am too busy to even call people. I'm not a natural pastor. I'm developing my pastoral grace. I'm a prophet. In Africa, where I came from, are people who bother about calling people to pray for them, to look for them. How are you? Are you not in church today? Okay, Father, my pastor is praying for you. Come to church. That is their own edict. That is the trouble of Pastor Grace here. Now, that is their destiny. Pastor Joy, Pastor Johnson, that is their destiny. I don't have the patience calling people on phone to look for them. I don't know how to do it. My job is to pray and intercede for people. So Emma didn't call her. She caused strange miracles. And then as she was enjoying, this has happened. Breakthrough has entered. He said, I don't need to pray again.
You see?
And then the devil struck. He said, where did I go to get the breakthrough? Then she remembered my name. He said, She even thought I won't have her number anymore. So she put up a call and started introducing herself. I am that woman that met you in Atlanta. I am that woman that gave your wife shoe. I am that woman that paid for your hotel bill. I am that. Everything was good for me until now. My life is bad now. Please call. I need prayer now. I said, where have you been? He said, everything was good until now. So it became good and you forgot God. When it was good, you didn't remember my number. May the mercy of God locate you.
Amen.
I think he said, I need the mercy of God. When people get their miracles, it appears they always forget me.
Yeah.
When there is trouble, that's when they remember me. It used to be very bad in those days. I broke the curse. When they don't have anything to eat, it's me they remember. When there is food to eat, they don't remember me. One day I said, God, I didn't come to die here for anybody. You die for all of us. I'm not Savior. I will say this to somebody who cares to hear. Stop practicing religion. Start serving Jesus. Stop practicing, it is my church. Your church has not delivered you. Deliver yourself from the church. Somebody listen to me. Stop. I'm a Catholic. You hear me say, I cannot live Catholic, but man of God, keep praying for me. Then keep your problem. If Catholic cannot catholize you. You better change before they kill you. Stop being religious. Somebody hearing me tonight?
Yes.
The woman called me, said, this and this, that. Oh, long story. I said, see me in church and I'll pray for you. He said, man of God, I believe the God that is using you, you can pray on the phone and you will answer. I said, before he used to answer, now that God has traveled. Now he's residing in Woodbridge now. If you come to Woodbridge, you will meet him.
That's it.
You can't keep me on 2 hours on phone. Come to church. He said, okay, I will think about it. I said, keep your prayer.
Okay.
I'm telling you, he saw me that we answer the prayer. You have to obey the voice of the prophet. People of God, can you love Jesus this 1 year and come and see how he beautify your life? Just love him. Please stop practicing religion. Stop talking scripture without faith. Stop saying I have faith, but you living in fear. Stop living back. Stop practicing what you are preaching. Do what? Love God. Serve Him. Let me say one more thing. Number 2, show mercy to people. Matthew chapter 5 verse 7. He that showeth mercy shall receive mercy. If you want to have mercy from God, also show mercy to somebody. Jesus said, blessed are they that are merciful, for they shall receive what? Mercy. When you see those in pain, but you refuse to touch them, to help them, when you know you have the ability to help them, you are not merciful. When you see a pastor that is wearing one pants trouser every day, change his pants trouser for him. Be merciful to him. Don't be coming to church with the best of the car and your pastor is driving a rickety car. Show him mercy. Is somebody hearing me now?
Yes.
There are Christians, I'm telling you, Christians are more wicked than Muslims. Muslims will buy cars for their far, build houses for their far. Christians will say, how can my pastor be more rich than me? Pastor is enjoying too much. Have you had a Muslim complain about their priest?
No.
Have you heard about a Catholic complain about their pope? But Pentecostals complain about their pastors every time. They are not Pentecostals, they are Pentecostals. They come to church, they fight. And they sit speaking in tongues. Pentecostals. Show mercy. Somebody shall show mercy. Show mercy by paying your tithes to the church. It belongs to God. Don't deprive God of what belongs to Him. Show Him mercy. He provided for you. Show Him mercy. Don't let His work die on earth. Show mercy to the things of God. Show mercy. Be interested in the things of God. Do you know that your spontaneous offering can change a lot of things in the house of God?
That's right.
In my Lagos church, one day, one man came and said, Pastor, this chair is too dirty. Are there no workers in this church that cleans chairs? I say, woman, there's no problem if you also can bend down and clean. You sit on it, somebody is doing it. You yourself do it today. Stop complaining nobody is doing something. Nobody, in this church, there is no love. It's because you love nobody. In this church, nobody has visited you. Who have you visited? Show mercy to somebody and then you receive mercy.
That's right.
In this place, I did my birthday. Nobody even gave me a gift. Who did you give gift to when they did their own birthday?
Complain.
People who complain in the church, they are Pentecostals.
Yes.
That church talks too much money, but it is money that bought the chair that you are sitting on.
Yeah.
Is somebody hearing me?
Yeah.
Thank God for our meeting. We don't talk too much money there, but it is money that is paying for this bill for us to come. If we don't, they will drive. Anointing doesn't keep a place, they will drive you out. It's money. Somebody say money.
Money.
And you see, God is faithful because our merciful God is merciful to us.
Yes.
What you sow,
what you reap.
It's not prayer of mercy that brings mercy. It is what you do. That act of mercy. Because mercy is an act of God that introduces you to undeserved favor. So it is an act of yours that introduces you to his mercy. Solomon acted before God, sacrificed. He got mercies of God. David acted, sacrificed. He said, I will not sacrifice anything that does not cost me anything before the Lord. And he got the mercy of God. Jacob raised an altar for God. And God said, Jacob, Jacob. He said, oh, what is it? What is it? He said, my name is Jacob. He said, from today, we shall be a priest unto God. How? He raised an altar for God. He showed God's mercy. He said, your name shall be erected on this place. This place shall be called Bethel. Jacob built an house for God. God said, oh, then I forget all your evil. You may call him a cheat, but God wiped it away. How many evil do you know you have committed and yet God didn't kill you? Just mercy of God. If you are looking for the worst and cheapest sinner on the surface of the earth, I'm number one. But yet God choose and look at me, you stupid boy, go and preach for me. You are the one that will work for me. There are people who are better qualified than me and they are nowhere. Mercy. You know what Paul says? He said, I'm the chiefest of all sinners. He killed, he murdered, he wasted the church. God said, Paul, you shall become an apostle. Peter said, over there, dead boy, you cannot preach for Jesus. When we were following, you were nowhere. You were killing us. And they refused to introduce Peter, even in the church. But God said, Peter, you shall be a preacher to the Gentiles. You shall write scripture more than any other apostles. Mercy of God located Paul. May the mercy of God locate you.
Amen.
When you remember those who are under you, you attract God's mercy. Finally, I want you to stand up to take this. Because we are going to the last. In Exodus chapter 33, verse 17. What will expose you to the mercy of God? Number three. Is prayer. Someone say prayer.
Prayer.
Jabesh prayed. Jacob prayed. Solomon prayed. David prayed. Everyone that attracted the mercy of God, they cry to God. When you cry to him, he can show you mercy. If you don't behave like you don't need God, stop behaving as if you don't need God. You need God to survive. And Moses took the tabernacle and pitched it without the camp, afar off from the camp, and called the tabernacle the tabernacle of the congregation. And it came to pass that everyone which sought the Lord went out unto the tabernacle of the congregation, which was without the camp. No, look at verse 17, so that we can be fast. Verse 17. And the Lord said to Moses, I will do these things also that thou hast spoken, for thou hast found grace. Another word for grace is mercy. For thou hast found mercy in my sight, and I know thee by name. And the Lord said unto, I will do these things also that thou hast spoken, for thou art find mercy in my sight. May you find the mercy of God in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
So when Moses prayed, God said, you have found mercy. And I will do all that you have said. All, not some. So whatever you say tonight, all, it will meet with the mercy of God tonight.
Yeah.
You didn't say believe in
amen.
Yeah. Is there anything you want to say to the Lord tonight? Open up your mind and begin to see them.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, yes, Lord, I'm a sinner. I've sinned against you, so
Mercy will locate you. Talk to me. 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 Lord, let your mercy. I know I'm nobody. But have your mercy. Talk to him. Say, Lord, I cry for your mercy tonight. I sought your mercy tonight. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
The believers, amen.
Amen.
I want us to quickly pray these three prayer points and then we end it tonight. Who has received the mercy of God tonight? And is this mercy that we guarantee this answer prayers tonight in the name of Jesus?
Amen.
Lift up your hands and say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Father, in the name of
say it again. Say it aloud.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Shout it one more time.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
I uproot
anything whatsoever
that will limit your power of mercy in my life this year. They are uprooted in the name of Jesus. Turn into prayer right now. Anything and whatsoever will limit your power of mercy over my life this year, they are uprooted. Lift up your voice, lift up your voice, lift up your voice. Lift up your voice, somebody lift up your voice. Pray like a believer. Whatever will limit your power of mercy in my life, let it be uprooted. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Satan say,
oh Lord,
in the name of Jesus, my destiny shall not be attacked in 2015 in the name of Jesus. By your mercy, my destiny shall not be destroyed in the year 2015 by your mercy. Oh Lord, my destiny shall not come under attack in 2015. Lift up your voice and pray in the name. My life shall not come under attack by your mercy. Lift up that voice, Lord, by your mercy. My life, my family, my finances, my ministry, my progress, my breakthrough shall not come under attack this year. In the name of Jesus, my life shall not come under attack this year. Lift up that prayer, lift up your voice. Pray like a warrior. Pray like a warrior. Pray like a warrior. Pray like a warrior. My children will not come under attack. My husband will not come under attack. My wife will not come under attack. My breakthrough shall not come under attack. Our ministry shall not come under attack. Our church shall not come under attack. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
My life shall not come under attack. In the name of Jesus. Nothing in our life shall come under attack. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Every good thing that 2014 consumed and wasted, by the mercy of God, let 2015 release it to you.
Ah, your amen should be louder.
Every good thing that 2014 wasted, in the name of Jesus, by the mercy of him that gathered us tonight,
may 2015 release it to you.
In the name of Jesus.
Say thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Shout again. Say thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
I am connected to your mercy.
I am connected to your mercy.
I walk in your mercy.
I walk in your mercy.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' most powerful name we pray.
Amen.
Come on, give him a shout of and a praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy. He's worthy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Our time is up. Hallelujah. I'd like you to take an offering tonight.
Thank you, Jesus.